All right, what's up? I am Evolving Wisdom, and yes, I am still evolving. All right, so I am going to do a reading for my Geminis. Now, you guys are my babies. I really do dig Geminis a lot. You're so fucking smart. I love talking to you guys. You guys have so much information stored up. It's almost amazing. You guys do jump though to subject to subject. You just, it's kind of difficult for a person who is very intuitive and very aware of people's, you know, how they look and how they're acting, because I can tell when you guys do this gaze. It's almost like you're trying to make the person who you're, whoever you're talking to, you're trying to make them believe that you're listening to them when you're really not. And I catch you guys on that all the time, because you really hate when someone repeats the same thing, or they're telling you some information that you are already are informed on. So you will kind of like drift off into outer space. Air signs, but overall, I love you guys. You're so you're very friendly when you do like someone. Off the top, you know, when you first meet people or people first meet you, you're very kind and very knowledgeable and very informative. Just Geminis are the smartest signs of the zodiac, the intellect. They want to know everything. And I really dig that. I really dig that. So I do draw a lot of Geminis into my life. But on the other side, flip side of things, you guys can be so decisive. Like, you can't make your mind up. It's either, you know, one minute you like this, one minute you like that, one minute you like the person, one minute you don't like the person. And I think it comes from a lot of times of you just not being comfortable with expressing how you truly feel. As far as like, hey, I didn't like when you did this, I didn't like when you do that. You pretty much just kind of distance yourself from that person and you move on very fast. You don't really talk about it unless you like truly, truly care about that person and you want them in your life. Other than that, you like, whatever, bye, I don't like you anymore. I liked you yesterday, but I don't like you now. These are the zodiac signs that, like, if you are in trouble or you need someone to defend you, those are the zodiac signs right there. That's one of the zodiac signs you want to go and get to help you, like, say, I'm just going into, like, the high school mode. If you in high school and you got some trouble with some girls or whatever, you're Gemini, that's the person you need to go and get, because they're going to be down for you. They down a ride or whatever. On the lower end spect of a Gemini, if you very low vibrational, I'm not going to say low vibrational, but if you are in like just the energy of like, you know, you just at this point in your life where you like, you just don't give a fuck or whatever. They don't play. Geminis, and I know a lot of times people call Geminis crazy and everything, but it's just because they can see the bullshit. Like, they really do. They can see, like, when you trying to play them or when you try, because they're very smart. Yes, they move fast. They move fast. So they can come off very, like, whoa, they're everywhere. They're airy, but they move fast. They can figure out shit really quick or whatever. And when I say when they don't like you, they don't like you. They can get very violent, especially the women. Especially the women. If you look up the Women's Institute, like in prison or jail or whatever, and you look up their zodiac signs, I guarantee you a lot of them are going to be Geminis, because they don't fucking play. Most air signs don't play, but Geminis especially. Those are your little soldiers right there, along with the Aries, the Taurus, the Scorpios. Now, the Taurus, it depends, but we're gonna get into that, because sometimes people have Tauruses misconstrued too. But anyways, Geminis, those are my boos or whatever. It's just... Y'all are wishy-washy. It's not wishy-washy. Let me stop. You're not wishy-washy. You just, when you don't like somebody no more, you don't like them. And you have a good reason why you don't like them. All right, so let's get into the reading of Geminis. My babies. As you can see, I have a lot of close friends who are Geminis. All right, let's find out what's going on with my Geminis here. What is going on with my Geminis? All right, Geminis, what's going on with you guys? All right, let me get a little bit more information here. If I start reading these cards. Oh, here we have one fly out. All right, Geminis. You're dealing with a new lover in your life. If they're not in your life right now, they're coming in. And I got a good feeling that they're coming in. This is the Jack of Cups here. It's just a reliable person that's in your life. Someone who's just down for you. You have a beautiful energy here. A woman who really loves you and care about you. That's looking out for you. Then you have the King of Cups here. And they're just a really honest, generous type of individual here. A very affectionate. Okay. Okay. So, we have the Jack of Spades, and then we have the King of Hearts. So, this person right here has a bad side to them. They seem like they're a very good person, but we all have negative sides to ourselves. Because they have the King of Hearts here also. Let me get more information before I like to just start reading here. Success, your money, wealth, your wishes, your things as far as when it comes to your money is on the rocks. It's not on the rocks, I'm sorry. It's really going well here. You have some departure here, like you're trying to get away from some type of energy here. Maybe this new lover, he started off very affectionate right here. Affectionate, very loving, but then you start seeing more of who they are. You wanted to depart from them. You got your wishes coming in. You got some surprises coming in. Unexpected good luck coming in for you. As if I'm hearing. In a way, I am hearing what's going on. You got a third party here. You got some woman coming in here. It's the trouble. It's trouble in this relationship here. This person started off very kind, very affectionate, and you know, kind of fooled you in the beginning. You thought they were good. You thought this was like your soulmate. And then you start finding out some shit. You start finding out that they had someone else, that they were not who you thought they were. So you tried to depart from them. You tried to separate yourself and pull away from them. And they're not having it. Joker. You have some change coming in here. Change. There is some change coming in. Let's see why this change is coming in. Does it have anything to do with this relationship? Yes. You have the Seven of Hearts. Unfaithful. Just not a reliable person here. Someone who you thought that you can trust in. and you found out that they was not who they said they were. They full of shit. They unreliable. They not trustworthy. Because why? Because they have somebody else. They got somebody else in the mix. They've been dealing with this person way before you came into the mix. They actually live with this person. They actually live with this person. If they don't live with this person, they're very close to this person. And at the moment, they were going through some stuff. That relationship was going through some stuff. So they started being a person who they were and started looking outside of that relationship. And they ran into you. And the person, the male or the female, was very affectionate towards you, very caring, very all about you in the beginning. So who in their right mind wouldn't think that, who would think that they had somebody else? I'm sorry, my cards fell. All right, let's find out what's going on with Geminis. Let's find out what else. Jack of Diamonds here. Just dishonest, unreliable, just a dishonest person. They lied to you. They led you on. They made you believe something that was not there. And you remember, I told you guys that we were in Neptune was in Pisces, which is the planet. The Pisces is in its planet, which is Neptune, the house of illusion, the house of mirrors. You know, you see or you feel what you want to feel. It's really not what it is. So you have to be careful here. Okay. Is there anything else you want to say? There's some money. There's some issues surrounding. There's some issues surrounding money. And there's some issues surrounding your relationship. Okay, I want to go into my fairy card here. Go a little deeper here. Well, not go a little deeper here because I think my playing cards is going to really go as deep as it can. All right. So we have the Two of Winter here. Indecision is holding you back. Make the choice that's best for you rather than trying to please others. Feeling trapped between the intellectual and the emotion. What decision do you have to make? Like, you know that, Geminis, you know that this relationship ain't right. You know, you're gonna know that something's not. People are not who they say they are. You know, once this is done, once you make the decision, instead of using your intellectual abilities, what I'm saying is get out the emotions and use more of like, come on, like, okay, he did this or she did this on this day and this is not adding up. You know, you're gonna have happiness here. Can you see this? You're gonna have happiness. Look at them, they're playing in the water, they're enjoying themselves around with their friends. It's like, it's bliss, it's heaven. You know, it's called the Three of Summers. It says news worth celebrating. And announcements such as weddings, graduations, or births, friends, and cherish. Everything will work out. Let that shit go. It was something you needed to learn and something you also need to separate yourself with. You got your prince coming in. You got your prince, you got your queen, or prince or queen coming in, okay? A passionate relationship comes in after this. Once you let that damn person go, and you stop pussyfooting around with them, and know, and just stand up and be like, I don't deserve this. I deserve the world. I deserve happiness. I deserve someone who's not going to lie to me, because I don't lie. You know, you are, and you know what? A lot of times people say you are who you attract. I don't believe in that. I just don't say things just because it's the thing to say. I believe you are who you decide to keep around, because you can attract many people to you. You can attract many beings or things to you. It does not mean that you want to keep their company around you. You know, so just because these things, these people are coming to you and everything does not mean that you have to entertain this. You are not who you attract. You are who you keep around and decide to entertain. Okay. So this person, as you can see there on the horse, they're looking for you. You know, your love, your true love, your soulmate. Okay. What else do my Pisces need to know? Look at this. What is? What? Can you see this? It's your boo. This is your boo right here. Four of Springs. Be grateful with you. Be grateful. You have much to celebrate. Deep feelings of peace and happiness. A content personal life. What did I just say? Let that bullshit go so you can get this. So you can get your happiness. Look, marriage, true happiness here. Don't feel bad. Don't feel bad that you was deceived by this person. Don't feel bad that this person came into your life and was just a wolf or a snake and they had no good intentions, because you learned you're going to grow from this. You're going to be so wise. You're going to know when this person comes into your life, you're going to know, okay, this is the real thing here. That other shit I was dealing with in the past, no. But this right here, you're going to know, because you cannot have darkness without understanding. You can't have the darkness and the bad times, because you will not understand the light and the goodness. So it's a part of life. Don't feel bad, because I know how Geminis can be. You know, you feel like, shit, I'm too smart for this. How the hell did this person deceive me like this? It happens. But you're going to learn a lot, you know? We all learn. And that's what this life is about. It's about learning. It's about growing. It's about evolving. Okay? I love you, Geminis. I really do. I really do. I love you guys. And I really believe in you all. You all have your purpose. And I believe in you. And if you want a further reading from me, a personal reading from me, go to aravenwisdom.com and see what I offer there. I offer so much services when it comes to healing, especially negative healing. I offer services and products. All right, Geminis.